I started EFE 20 years ago, the need for job training in the Middle East. You have youth there as talented as anybody I found in the US, but the things they were learning, the tools they were given, were tools that were mismatched to the labor market.
I am a woman in Palestine, especially from Jenin City, studying nursing. Regardless of all of the struggles I faced at first from my surrounding, yet I insisted on the following my passion.
If I did not follow my dreams and I let other people's expectations restrict me, I would never have moved forward with my life.
Can you share with us how the pandemic has accelerated the healthcare services sector, and also how is that forcing innovation and scale?
They say one of the areas of investment that have taken a hit includes healthcare. However, there are some areas in healthcare sector which are now doing better than before.
The three sectors that I see that will boom is number one, healthcare, as my previous speaker. Number two, digital transformation. And third, logistics.
If we talk about physical supply chains, maybe under stress, there's a big push now towards localizing those physical supply chains. But at the same time, there's an opportunity for, you know, still for globalization in terms of talent.
The globalization, as it were, of the workforce provides a lot of opportunities that may not have been there previously. I think as we look at our programs and our digitization going forward, I think that's something that we need to be very conscious of.